Alright, fellow YouTubers, so we're in a complete quarantine now, so I'm gonna pop a couple videos for you guys. Long story short, today we working with the footage from a Raw film. Be sure to check them out. I have all the links in the description below. I have also 25% discount link if you guys are interested in stock footage. So check it out, all the links in the description below. So we're working with a couple shots today, shot on red camera. And by the way, I'm going to say it again, it doesn't matter what camera it is, as long as the material shot correctly, you can color grade it. So always keep that in mind. I constantly keep getting questions about log, S-Log2, and all kinds of different variations. I'm telling you guys again, it doesn't matter. Get it right in camera and you can color grade any footage. So here's what we have. We have a rider on the motorcycle. We have two different clips. So I'm going to be working with IPP2, red, white gamut, log 3G10. I'm going to do the same for this project. I mean, for this clip. I'm sorry, I'm getting crazy a little bit. Log 3G10. So now they kind of matching, so we can work around. So let me play it back really quick so we kind of see what we're dealing here. We have a female riding a bike, and then it cuts to a different shot. So pretty cool. All right, so let's get started. The first thing I'm gonna do, actually probably I can work with this clip. Let me make the screen a little bit bigger for you. I'm gonna loop it. The first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna create a new node, Alt S, okay, and then I'm immediately going to convert it to parallel, Alt B. And the reason why I'm doing this, because I want to do the least destructive process when color grading. And when you work with the serial nodes, it is a little bit destructive. So parallel is the least destructive. Now the downside of it, they getting mixed, so you get a little bit less effect when you're working with the parallel. But I have dedicated video if you guys want to check it out. Type it in my channel, it's all in there. Anyways, so the first one gonna be saturation. Okay, saturation. Okay, and by the way, if you just tuned in, we are gonna be doing Top Gear style color grading. So I'm gonna try to match a typical Top Gear kind of look.
Oh my god. Hammond!
So in the saturation node, I'm simply going to pop a little bit of saturation. And right away, we have much more natural, much more vivid shot. So in the second one, I'm gonna call this one contrast. Okay, contrast. And in the contrast, you can use few things. You can either stretch it manually, gain and lift, you can use offset, or you can just pop the contrast wheel right over here. So that's what I'm gonna do. So let's take a look specifically on the parade. One thing that people do mistake, you see how at the bottom it start getting compressed. Watch this. You see how it's being compressed? That's the thing we want to avoid. We don't want to be compressing or crushing any shadows. So when you have this compressed, make sure to use pivot to counter that. And if it's still not looking correct, I highly recommend resetting it and just using a little bit less aggressive method. Or if you continue seeing that, just do it manually by stretching shadows and highlights. That way you guys preserve the most amount of data. You don't want to compress anything from the very beginning of the color grading. It's very important. So we have saturation, we have contrast. I'm gonna do Alt P. I'm gonna do saturation number 2 because I feel like there's still not enough saturation at the moment. Let's check out really quick the vector scope. Yep, it's still a little bit desaturated, so I'm gonna pop a little bit more saturation, just like this. And like I mentioned earlier, you have much less effect when you work with the layer, but everything being parallel, so it's all being preserved nicely. Now, typical with the red cameras, watch out for chroma noise. And as we can see here, we actually see a lot of chroma noise. Now, if I'm gonna toggle everything, Shift D, we can see that the noise present even without color grading. So keep your eye on that as well. Okay, so we're gonna need to handle that a little bit. So let's go in the first node. Okay, I'm going to zoom in to her pants, or just in general to the black color. Let's go to motion effect, and over here I'm gonna uncheck them, those guys, ungang them, and I'm just gonna do a little bit chroma noise reduction. And we can see that we still have noise, but we no longer have chroma noise, and basically now it looks a little bit more organic, like a film grain. So again, let's toggle before and after. We can see a little effect of that. So that is very good for the beginning. So let's start injecting the look how we want and start doing the more stylized stuff. So with the black gear, with the top gear, I'm going completely crazy here with all the quarantine. They usually pretty crunchy. They usually have very deep blacks, which that's what I'm gonna do, as you can see over here. Also, make sure, it's very important, make sure that you're not clipping channels individually, because quite often people do that, and that's something you want to avoid. So now the image looks very nice, very crisp. Let me see if I can do a little extra pop. Let's see really quick. All right, that looks good. So I'm gonna call this one contrast as well. I'm slowly building the look. Now let's do the sky. I'm gonna type in sky. And over here in the sky, I'm gonna go hue versus saturation. And I'm gonna tap right over here. And we can see that little spike of the blue. And what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna increase it a little bit. And now it's very important to stretch it a little bit. So we're feathering, we make that selection softer. That way everything looks nice. Because a lot of times, if you're gonna do it like that, you're gonna have abrupt bending possibly. So always be sure that you're doing nice feathering. And also when you do nice feathering, make sure you're not touching the channels that you don't want to be affected. Otherwise, you're gonna start introducing a lot of artifacts. So here's what we have, hue versus saturation. Now we're gonna go hue versus hue. Again, I'm gonna select that blue. And now with that blue, I'm just simply gonna pop it up a little bit. And again, I'm gonna feather it. We see that kind of color a lot in the top gear. They usually do a little bit crazy artistic looks like that. So this is good. Now, because I'm working with the sky, I also can do parallel. I can continue working in a parallel. And now I'm gonna add a little bit of vignette. Okay, and adding vignette is very simple. I'm gonna show you a couple tricks. First, I wanna do a typical BBC kind of style vignetting on top. Okay, they usually go pretty dark with it. So let's bring it down and leave it a little bit like that. Now, this kind of looks a little bit awkward, right? So what we can do, we can actually make this to be behind the helmet. And what we have to do, just select the background over here into qualifier. And let's make sure that everything is selected nicely. We have the whole helmet covered. Let's add a little bit of blur. Okay. Let's denoise it a bit. Let's see, let's do clean white and a little bit black. And we have this, let's see, blur in and out. Okay, like that is good. So let's check it out, before and after. We kinda added this vignette behind the helmet. Now, if you feel like it's a little bit too strong, you can go to key and just simply dial it down to make a little bit less subtle effect. All right, so that looks cool. Let's continue. Let me just organize this a little bit. Okay, just like this, contrast. Okay, that way we preserving all the space so you guys can see the maximum size picture. All right, now we're gonna do a little bit of ground. Okay, so ground. We can use the same technique or we can use secondaries. So for the sake of tutorial, let me use secondaries right now. So I'm gonna click right over here. Okay, and we can see we have a very nice selection from the very beginning. Okay, now if you have a little bit of highlight over here, it is okay because we have the sun behind her, so it's kind of same color as the background, so that works. It's not always works, but in certain situation it works and it's okay to leave it like that. Okay, now we have this little bit dancing noise. That's something we really need to get rid of. So let me select this. Let me finesse selection a little bit. Let's see how that's doing. Okay, that's kind of okay for what we're doing. It's gonna work. Let me again, let's see, feather it a little bit like this. And let's see. Okay, so for what we're doing, it works. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna pop a little bit saturation. I'm gonna add a little bit of contrast. Okay, and look at this picture. Look right away what we've done. So before and after. That is such a small adjustment, but already our image started looking very high-end, like it's been shot with additional lighting and everything nice and contrasty and saturated. So everything looks really cool. But we're gonna continue refining all this. So that looks really cool. Now, I'm gonna do another note. And in this note, I want to add a little bit of extra depth to what we're doing. So now in the qualifier, I'm going to go just to Luma. Okay. And just with Luma, I'm going to select a little bit back of her jacket. So the shiny part. Okay. Now with the Luma, I'm going to start going back a little bit. Let's see, something like that. I want to make sure I have nice feather. Okay, so this is perfect. As you can see, it's very nice and clean selection. And we can do a couple things here. We can either pop contrast a little bit here. Okay, if we don't want to pop contrast, we can actually use curve to give contrast a little bit like that. So whatever method you're going to use, it's up to you. So I'm going to call this one punch. And simply, I'm just going to do with the contrast. And we can see that it's adding even more dimension. Now, with this punch, I can use pivot to dial whenever it needs to be. And I think, as of right now, this shot looks pretty cool. It started taking shape. So that's good. Again, that's ground. That's punch. I'm going to do a new node. So now we can kind of start building the overall look. I want to make a feel that it's in a desert somewhere, you know, it's a nice hot day. So I can do this simply with the curves. I'm going to go and click B for blue channel. And I'm just going to start bringing down the bright side of it. And we can see we start introducing a very cool look like this. So just by simple adjustment, we completely altered how this image looks. Just like this. So I'm going to call this one blue. Actually, I'm going to call this one warm. Okay, so that looks really cool. Now, before we're going to continue, let me paste this look over here and see how it looks here. So obviously, there is a problem in this shot because exposure between them is a little bit different. So let's see. The problem is in our vignetting. Okay, we can fix that. So let's go again in the qualifier here. I don't really need qualifier because there is no helmet in this shot. Everything looks really cool. So here we have it. Let me do really quick. Full screen, before and after. Before and after. What a huge difference, right? Now we can add a little bit extra production value. So let's do a new node. And I'm going to call this one focus. Let's do it like that. And with the focus, what I can do a simple vignette over here like this. Okay, select, let me find a good shot. Okay, so this is a good shot. Okay, like that. And I can just drop everything else, let me invert that, everything else make a little bit darker, okay, like this. And if I want to, I can even blur it out just a tiny bit. Now, I personally not a fan of doing this, so I'm just going to leave focus to be with the Luma instead of artificially doing that. So now I'm going to go into tracking, make sure you have pan, tilt, zoom, rotate, and perspective, and let's track this forward. So that looks really cool. Okay, let's see. And take off. All right, that looks perfect. Now from this point, let's track backwards to make sure that we got the entire picture. Okay, so that looks great. Now, on this node selected, click Control C, go in this shot, create a new node, Alt S and Control V. We're gonna paste this. And what we're gonna do now, we're just going to make this one a little bit bigger. Okay, just like that. And we're going to do tracking again from the beginning. That way we have a nice fresh tracking data. Okay, that looks really cool. So now let me hide all the stuff. Okay, let's go back and let's play it back full screen and see what we've done. So we have nice vignette, we have a nice motorcycle, all the colors look nice and good, very cinematic. Something that Top Gear definitely would do, especially in their new Grand Tour series. All right, that's cool. And now for to put a little cherry on top, let's go into timeline node. Let's create a new node over here, and I'm gonna add a little bit of film grain. Let's see where it is. Let's see, I'm completely lost. Let's just type in film grain. Okay, there we go. I like film grain to be aggressive, so 16 millimeter might be perfect. Let's see, okay, this one is pretty awesome. But I don't want film grain to be all over the image. What I want, film grain only be in the highlights. So again, I'm gonna go on the qualifier in the Luma, and I'm gonna start rolling it down. Okay, we can see the selection over here. And once everything dark being deselected, I'm gonna feather it a little bit so the selection is nice and soft. Okay, and now it looks like a real 16 millimeter print. So again, full screen, let's check it out before and after. So here we have it, a very nice Top Gear look. If you guys interested, by popular demand, I'm gonna make this power grade available. I'm gonna put all the links in the description below. Stay safe, and I'm gonna see you guys in the next video. Take care.